2008, after the tsunami election, Transparency International came to see me and they said, let's draw up some recommendations to reform the finances of politics. At the time, Transparency International was led by Paul Lowe. Anyway, we drew up the recommendations. After a lot of research and debates, we drew it up. Just now, Chief Minister Guan Eng asked me, who exactly said no to you? And I blurted out to report, I want to apologize, I shouldn't just name one name. But this is what happened. We took our recommendations in about 2010 and we went to Parliament. And when we went to Parliament, we first went to a round table with opposition members. A lot of opposition members were there. And we tabled our reform recommendations. And to my surprise, the opposition members said no. And I asked them, why? Why are you saying no to us? I mean, I thought you will take our recommendations and run into the chamber and say, now let's table this for debate. Why are you saying no? And they said, no. We are saying no now because we are now getting money from businesses and we need this money to run the election. So I said, I think you better be clear. Let's draw a line in the sand and say, enough is enough, let's bring about the change. And they asked me why. I said, because the fact of the matter is Barisan Nasional will always get more money than you. It's never going to be an equal level playing field. And the discussion ended on that note. And as I was leaving, I remember Khalid Samad looked to me and he said, where are you going now? And I said, I'm going over to the other side to talk to the Barisan Nasional. And he said, good luck to you. And I said, Khalid, I know what to expect when I go there, but I didn't expect to hear what I heard today from you.
Thanks, Terence. Now, let me state here clearly and unequivocally that we support the reform in terms of political funding. And I've said this, I've not said this now, I've told this to G25. When they held forums in Penang, so I hope you can go back to the people in G25 and you can check with them. And I've said this publicly in Penang that we support proposals for public financing and also transparency in political financing. I would suggest that next time when you want to make this suggestions that you see me directly instead of probably some of my other leaders, because I really have to get back to them the basis for the so-called rejection. But as far as the party is concerned, we support any measures to level the playing field to promote transparency and accountability. I'm not telling you now, Terence. I said this before to G25. You check with them whether I didn't tell them or not.
Met the opposition in Parliament, we had a round table and they said no. Now let's leave aside individuals. Let's talk about that round table where they said no to this. So please, let's answer. Since you want an honest answer, I'm giving you an honest answer.
Alright, so from now on, can move on with that.
Just give me an honest reply that was an intent. Okay, and that's something that I only know about it after the fact. So what I'm saying is that as far as the position of my party is concerned and myself is concerned, when it was first brought up to me, without any hesitation, I said yes, we support political financing, transparency and accountability. I mean, like you say, it doesn't make sense for us to reject it. You level the playing field. And what you say is correct, Terence. They're going to get more money than you. Why don't we make it public? It's a no-brainer. So there's no reason for us to reject it, especially if it promotes accountability and transparency. And as I said, why don't you check with G25 people and let's settle this once more. We are really doing it now. How do we raise money? We raise money by selling tickets for our dinners. We raise money when in our dinners, we raise donations and we announce the amount raised publicly. And we submit these accounts to the RS, to the Registrar of Societies. We are really doing it now. We don't have any slush funds from overseas. So why are we worried? If we have $1 billion for one NDV, of course we have something to hide. We have nothing to hide. Oh, I wish we have some money for overseas. And if we raise money through the internet, it's all recorded. We have nothing to hide. We are really doing it now. Thank you.